This program is a major mod that we've incorporated to an aircraft that's been freshly designed and released and delivered to us. And to go back in there and remove it and gut it out and start all over again with some major modifications, it was quite an achievement.
It wasn't completely start to finish cast in stone when we started, and we're still working on it. But we'll see what happens when it takes off. I'm sure it'll be great.
We have probably the best group of electricians I've ever worked with. I mean, you don't have to follow up behind anybody or anything. It's just a joy.
We build them to fly. We don't build them to sit on the ground. And we like to see them up in the air.
It's been a very aggressive program. We've had a lot of issues along the way, but that's normal, and it's all coming together.
It's a huge sense of accomplishment to watch a first-cut airplane fly for the first time. A lot of sense of accomplishment there and pride.
To the Boeing company, it's going to be really exciting to be able to offer a production product to other customers. I think the rest of the world will be very excited after May 20th.
It'll be pretty exciting to see your plane move instead of in the hangar.
Probably the highlight of any aircraft program, I think, is to see the aircraft fly for the first time. Well, even more so is to see it land safely the first time.
I have one or two small pieces on that plane, and what I'll be thinking about when it flies is that's my little part, and it's taken off, and I have contributed to the next generation of early warning aircraft, and it'll be a tremendous amount of pride when I see her take off.
It's been a great culminating of both basically Boeing Australia and Boeing US working together, coming together, learning the same skills, learning new systems that both sides of the project have bought in, and it's all sort of culminating now with the plane coming together.
And the camaraderie with the group here working with the Australian team as well as the American team is different than what I've experienced in other programs, and I really appreciate that.
There's a lot of people here that have really put their heart and soul into coming up with, I think, the best product that we can make for not only for Australia but also for the customers that follow on to Wedgetail.
We've got a fabulous team. You come in every day and you enjoy it.
There's a great deal of pride and sense of commitment to what we're doing. And the really neat thing is that I can see that increasing dramatically as we get close to first flight. What a great event that's going to be.
You work on a project for so long and then you actually see your project go into effect and take off and everything works according to how you designed it and how you tested it. And it feels like I had a real big role in the aircraft.
I fully expect to have tears in my eyes, even though that's maybe not the politically correct thing, but I do, because it's been a long struggle, but it's been a struggle that has been very important in terms of seeing a lot of things and a lot of people and a lot of companies come together and work together for a great product.
When Wedgetail goes down the runway for the first time, for me it's great satisfaction, and I think satisfaction for the whole program. I'll be thinking of the thousands of Boeing men and women and the men and women of your suppliers who've contributed to Wedgetail to date.
In a way, we're witnessing history. We are seeing what has been a concept to date into reality. So we'll see what has been a model aircraft, a picture on the wall, become reality. And when it lifts off, I think all our spirits will be lifted with it.